Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Open your Bibles. We're going to Luke. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Y'all keep praying. Hallelujah. Luke 17, starting at 12. 17, starting at 12. Hallelujah. We got it together. As he entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance. And they raised their voices and called out, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." And when he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." And as they went, they were miraculously, this is the Amplified version, they were miraculously healed and made clean. One of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, glorifying and praising and honoring God with a loud voice. And he laid face down at Jesus' feet, thanking him. Amplified version says over and over. He was a Samaritan. And then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 of you cleansed? Where are the other 9? God, be with us now. Use your word, oh God. Find us in your word. Wash us in your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Wait to give the message at the thought at the end. But being thankful is just for, it isn't just for the holidays. We're coming upon, we're entering the moment now of the season of Thanksgiving. When we get together, we eat, we tell each other why we're thankful and why we're grateful. But this isn't just for this time. The Bible instructs us that we should give thanks in hallelujah. So gratitude is an attitude that comes from a consistent habit of giving thanks. We got to be consistent in giving thanks. Whether it's to each other, whether it is to God, we have to consistently find this bringing to get to. We have to consistently find ourselves just being thankful. Lord, I thank you. I remember growing up watching aunts and uncles and actually just my aunts when she would just my aunt, Sister Friars, and she would just walk through the house, and for no reason at all, she just, "Lord, I thank you." And I found myself doing it. I don't even know. I just could be walking up the stairs and, "Lord, I thank you." Because I see so many people that cannot walk up the stairs by themselves, that cannot push through by themselves, and we have every activity of our limbs. And the Bible instructs us that because we have these things, that we should enter into his gates with. Come on, y'all. Now mind you, there is a thanklessness. We have to be careful of that trait. And that trait is for unbelievers. I said, the trait of unbelievers is thanklessness. That means they don't show their gratitude. The things that people do for them, it's all right, but you know, you could have did a little bit better. We got to be careful of that. Even in the house of God, we come Sunday after Sunday, and some of us, we sit and be like, "Lord, you could have did a little bit better than that." We forget that he breathed fresh breath of life into us every day. We forget that he wakes us up, forgetting those things that we have all done, those little sins. trait for unbelievers, but the believers, we have a trait also, and it is gratitude. Anybody grateful for what he's done for you, and not only the things that he's done for you, but the fact that you're still here, the fact that he didn't leave you where he found you, the fact that he didn't leave you, he thought enough for you to take you from where you are and to move you to where you're going. I dare somebody to stand up on your feet and just for 30 seconds just begin to bless them, because he's not, you're not where he left you, but you are where he's taking you. Anybody agree? Come on, shout to your feet. Stand to your feet. Come on, stand to your feet. Bishop said I had 2 minutes yesterday, so I'm going to take this time to go to my seat, but I'm going to tell him I'm thankful for the things that he's done for me. I'm not ungrateful. And the signs of thanklessness is murmuring and complaining, being contentious, showing envy. Be careful of being envious. You can be envious and not even know it. But being ungrateful for what somebody has that you may can obtain yourself if you ask for it. Exhortation. Telling them who he is to you. Time after time. Telling them how much he means to you. That's like your loved one. I know you got loved ones that you have to tell them how much you appreciate them. So he said, tell them how much you mean to them. Tell them how also he is looking for a sacrifice. Bishop talked about this last night. When you're grateful, you gotta be able to sacrifice. Genesis 22, God told